welcome to this human interface. During this hearing, we produce fibrocartilage interface, and we need bone ingrowth. The weakest link of this procedure is at time zero during the shoulder arthroscopy. In order to have a successful repair, we need a strong and ideal initial fixation of the tendon to the bone. The repair could be either transocial or using ankles. Which are the ideal anchor characteristics? The size should be as small as possible. The pull-out strength should be high. The anchors should be easy of use, and they should have no long-term term effects. And ideally, the anchors should be dented. When we use anchors to the glenoid, we have the cortical bone, hard bone, and the anchors have a smaller diameter, and normally 1.5 mm. When we do rotator cuff repair, we have to deal with the fibrosis. The bone in this area is most of the time osteopenic and cancerous. And the diameter of the anchor should be larger. Usually we have to put anchors with diameters 2.8, 4.5, or 5.5. Concerning the size of the anchors, we have many anchors with many sizes. 4.5, 5.5, 5, 4.75 mm. The material of the anchors could be titan, could be PICA. PICA material is not absorbable. Could be biocomposite. Biocomposite material is absorbable and is osteoinductive. And we have also the new generation anchors, the old suture anchors. Here we see such kind of an anchor, it's old suture anchor. And, we drill the bone, and after drilling, we put inside the bone, the cancerous bone, the anchor. And when we pull against the cortical bone, we form we form the anchor like a ball, and we have resistance to the cortical bone under the surface of the cortical bone. The shape of the anchors could be also different. We have many shapes. And we have two kinds of anchors, knotless anchors and suture anchors. When we use knotless anchors, we don't have to do knots. When we use suture anchors, we have sutures and we must do knots. There are also the bended anchors. The bended have small holes inside them, and we have the advantage that from the bone come growth factors towards the healing part of the tendon. The sutures, the material is an ultra high molecular weight polyethylene, and we have either sutures or tapes. The advantage of the tape is that the pressure against the surface we need to heal, to be cleared, is greater than if we have sutures. But the handling of a suture is easier than a tape. Okay, we have here we have anchors. By them we have anchors where we need to drill the bone, and we have anchors when we should impact the bone. These anchors with the bone impaction are better because we don't have to remove bone of this area. So we have multiple those types of anchors, different types for different situations and pathologies, and we should use the anchors as an individualized therapy. Now I will say a few words for the notes. There are three kinds of notes, and either we use half pixies, that's the simplest kind of noting. Sliding note outside the skin, and then we pull the post and we press the note until it comes to the tendon. Here I will speak in Greek. Τώρα, έχουμε τις δύο άκρες από τα ράματα, την αριστερή άκρη την κάνω αρχικά κοντή, είναι το post. Ουσιαστικά κάνω μια φιλιά για το δάχτυλό μου με το sliding note. Μια φιλιά, δεύτερη φιλιά. Και ουσιαστικά βάζω τη μία άκρη του ράματος στην πρώτη τρύπα που δημιουργείται και δημιουργώ τον αρχικό sliding note. Το άσπρο είναι το post μου και ουσιαστικά όταν σχηματιστεί αυτός ο κόμπος, τραβάω το post και κατεβάζω τον κόμπο προς την άκρη. Και ουσιαστικά μετά με το note pusher συνεχίζω με τους απλούς hard pitches. Is the nice note from introduced by Boileau, French soldier surgeon. And here we have these steps for this kind of noting. The second video. Εδώ αρχικά ουσιαστικά έχουμε στο ένα μας άκρο έχουμε φέρει μια φιλιά εκτός του δέρματος και στο άλλο χέρι έχουμε τα δύο άκρα του ράματος. Άρα έχουμε μια φιλιά και δύο άκρα ράματος. Αυτός είναι ο nice note. Παίρνω την αριστερή φιλιά από πάνω, το δάχτυλο, κάνω μια, το διασταυρώνω ουσιαστικά, έχετε κάτω και μέσα και τα δύο άκρα τα περνάω μέσα από την αρχική φιλιά. Αυτό όλο γίνεται εκτός σώματος, έχουμε τα δύο άκρα και ουσιαστικά αυτά τα δύο άκρα τα τραβάμε τα εναλλάξια προσεκτικά να μην φύγει εκεί η άγκυρα. Κατεβαίνει ουσιαστικά όλο αυτό το σύστημα του κόμπου προς τα κάτω και πάνω σε αυτό μετά με τον νότο που σε κάνω τους υπόλοιπους απλούς κόμπους εναλλάξει μέχρι να κλειδώσουν. Αυτός ουσιαστικά ο κόμπος είναι θεωρητικά πιο ισχυρός και έχει, επειδή είναι διπλό το ράμα, έχει αυξημένες πιέσεις, πιέζει περισσότερο την περιοχή που θέλουμε να πιέσουμε. Okay. Thank you very much for your